Hey guys, what's happening? And welcome to another episode of Any Metal Viking with me, your host Viking. Today I'm doing a review of both seasons of Tokyo Ghoul. Main reason being is because, well, to try and split this over two videos would be a little bit too long, and also basically this can be, both seasons can be summarized as the number of episodes would basically consist of a regular season of a normal TV show. So yeah, let's get into this. Okay, we're going to start with Tokyo Ghoul, the first season. Tokyo Ghoul, basically, without giving too much of the story away, although I would like to warn ahead of time, there are some spoilers in this review for those of you who haven't seen it. So if you haven't seen it, I suggest you stop watching this video immediately. So anyway, Tokyo Ghoul, the synopsis of the story is basically, it is about this college student named Kaneki Ken, and he goes on a date with a girl that he meets in a coffee shop one day, and then his date goes horribly wrong when he finds out that the girl that he likes is actually a ghoul and she tries to eat him. And when this girl just so happens to die, her organs are transplanted into his body, and as a result he becomes half human, half ghoul. And yeah, that's pretty much where the story picks up from there. So yeah, basically, ghouls in the story, they live amongst humans, they feed off humans. It is interesting in the fact that it's creatures that have never really had any focus on before. I mean, with vampires and werewolves are becoming such a cliche. I mean, as cool as they are, like, I'm not denying that there aren't some cool shows regarding vampires and werewolves out there. It's just, we've seen vampires and werewolves before, so now we've got ghouls. Now, basically, yeah, this show, interesting in that concept, but otherwise not very original at the same time. But then again, nothing really is original anymore, so yeah. Anyway, so basically Kaneki goes through this kind of journey in this first season. He's basically a real wimp of a character. At times, in fact most of the time throughout the series, he is very annoying in the terms of the choices that he makes and just his overall whininess. Now, that's generally for the most part of these episodes, but then again, despite Kaneki supposedly being the main character of this series, we do have other characters who make up for that. We have Toka, who is a really cool, badass female ghoul. We have other characters as well, some strange and odd characters like Tsukiyama. He is just the most oddball character, and for those of you who have watched the series, you know who he is. He's that fucked up dude who wants to eat Kaneki, and he literally is the craziest motherfucker out there in all of anime. Right from how he dresses to the way he acts, just about everything about him is fucked up and crazy. Then we got others. Hinami is quite an adorable character, nice and kind of lightens the mood of the very grim story. We have characters like Amon as well. Amon is pretty cool. Yeah, basically ghouls, although they live amongst humans, they are practically monitored and sometimes hunted, or in fact most of the time hunted, by an organization called the CCG, and I cannot remember what CCG stood for. In fact, I don't think they mentioned it in the show, or they might have, I don't know. But CCG basically monitors ghouls, and if ghouls take things too far, they obviously step in and kind of, you know, hunt them down, track them, kill them, sometimes take them to prison, But most of the time it's more killing than taking to prison. So anyway, yeah, basically, the investigators are referred to as the Doves or something like that. I don't know if that's just like a nickname they got or something. I don't know why they're called the Doves, but anyway. And as a result, whenever ghouls go out to feed or whatever, they have to wear masks, because obviously if they get spotted by an investigator or something, they'll be recognized whenever they go out in public or something. So as a result, every single ghoul has a mask in this entire show. If you haven't noticed this by the artwork of Tokyo Ghoul in general, then I don't know. So anyway, with regards to the series, most of the episodes are kind of slow-paced. For those of you who don't like slow-paced stuff, you probably won't enjoy it as such. But come about episode 10, the third last episode of the season, things really do begin to pick up. And you begin to feel, okay, now the story is moving along somehow, somewhere. All the previous episodes kind of seem pointless, but that's just my opinion. Most build-up episodes, sometimes they seem pointless, but then at the end of the show you go, oh, actually they had some kind of meaning. That's what normally happens. So anyway, your first 9 episodes are kind of slow, sluggish, etc., but episode 10 things start to get very interesting, and the show ends on a really well done cliffhanger. I know a lot of people who've read the Tokyo Ghoul manga said it wasn't a very good cliffhanger, they should have added a little bit more to it, but whatever, I haven't read the manga, so I thought it was pretty cool. And it was a nice way to leave you on the edge of your seat, making you want to watch the next season. So, season one, the story, although it's a good story, more or less, the main problem with it is that we get introduced to characters, or it tries to focus on characters that we see throughout almost every single episode, but then they only touch on certain aspects of the character with regards to either their personality or their backstory, their origin, whatever, and then they don't go any deeper than that. They just touch on it and then, yeah. Kaneki does show most of the character development. Other characters more or less stay the same more or less as they are, but there are other characters who develop, like for example Nishiki. He definitely changes from the first two being episodes of being a total arsehole to someone who, once you understand him better, is actually a really nice guy, etc. Yeah, there's a lot of other character development, but not too much. It mainly focuses on Kaneki. And the plot seems to try to establish that this character is supposed to be important, this character is supposed to be important, which I'm sad to say, when I come up now with Tokyo Ghoul Route A, which is the second season, I'm going to elaborate, which is unfortunate about this, okay? And some characters highlighted that are supposed to be important, especially the main one who is supposed to be of utmost importance, is Rize, who is the girl that Kaneki had a crush on, dated, and then tried to eat him and she died. And she is the reason why he is half ghoul now. So anyway, and another thing I'd like to add before I go on to Route A is that in terms of horror, because this show is meant to be a horror, the first 2 or 3 episodes actually are quite scary psychologically, especially when Kaneki tries to accept and deal with the fact and is frightened by the fact that he has become half ghoul. And just the things that he goes through in the beginning of the series actually are pretty scary. So I think they should have kept the scary atmosphere a bit more. It kind of turns into just a gore action fest after that. But psychological part in the beginning is very good. I'm not going to lie about that. And then, unfortunately, we come to Tokyo Ghoul Route A, which is season 2 of this series. what can be said about this? Route A is garbage. I am not going to lie. Now, this is just my opinion, people. I know a lot of other people might disagree, etc. And that's fine. I'm not here to force opinions on anybody, but I personally thought Route A was the biggest load of shit I've ever seen in my entire life. Couple of reasons. It picks up literally where the first Tokyo Ghoul season left off. But the studio tells everyone ahead of time that this season is not a continuation of Tokyo Ghoul. It is an alternate universe, alternate retelling thing. I don't know why they didn't stick to the original, but whatever. And it was not meant to be viewed as a sequel. Well, how can it not be a sequel if you continued where the original series left off? If you wanted to do an alternate universe, you should have started from square one again, etc., and possibly made it better. But did they? No. Yes, what's wrong with this? It picks up where it left off, and then literally abandons the plot and everything and tries to cram too many other things from the original manga and the alternate retelling manga in one little 13 episode miniseries, and it's just ridiculous. I mean, and again, spoilers for those of you who haven't watched this. The plot jumps all over the place. For some reason or another, Kaneki joins the very people who tortured him and basically almost killed him. Why would you do that? And then other things, suddenly the CCG are now after this owl, because some ghouls have nicknames according to whatever the dubs or the investigators have seen by their masks. So, for example, Kaneki gets the name Eyepatch because he's a one-eyed ghoul. Only one of his eyes turns red and black like a ghoul's does, so he has to wear Eyepatch thing with his mask, so he gets the nickname Eyepatch. And then there's this other one called Owl. Now, the CCG try and focus on hunting the owl. Now, in the next day, they're trying to focus on hunting Kaneki, and they don't know where they want to go with this, while at the same time plotting some major war conflict for no fucking reason. Then we get thrown in the mix when Kaneki's with this group who tried to kill him, does a major prison break to break out some ghoul who's supposed to be very important. But I don't know, apparently Rize is important. It was emphasized so much in the first Tokyo Ghoul that Rize is a very important character, and they did not tell us why she's important. In fact, Rize doesn't feature anymore. She doesn't even appear in any of Kaneki's psychological hallucination things at all. I think she has like a brief cameo glimpse when he has a nightmare about Jason, the guy who tortured him or whatever. But she doesn't say anything, you just see her. And apparently Reese is so important because when they bust this guy out, he's supposedly some very powerful or experienced, seasoned, skilled ghoul. He beats the shit out of Kaneki just because he has Reese's scent on him, obviously, because he's got her organs in him. And then what? Like, then this other random ghoul chick appears and says, "Do you want to see Rize again?" And who was that guy? Well, what significance did he have to the story? What significance did that prison break even have to the story? And then there are other things as well. Like, Toko was such a badass. She was an strong, independent female role in the first season. And then after having her Kagane, which is what is a ghoul's like power kind of thing that they have, after her one gets eaten by her own brother, who is a lot stronger than her, despite being 14 years old, and he doesn't even look 14. He looks older than Kaneki, and Kaneki is such a wuss. She becomes a total one-dimensional, typical anime girl. And I'm not saying all anime girls are like this, but for those of you who watch anime, you know what I'm talking about. Your Orihime of Bleach, she kind of becomes like that. Oh, and it's just terrible. And the worst part is the middle part of the series, especially that fight scene I just mentioned between Kaneki and this dude that they're trying to bust out. The animation becomes cheap. Like, they literally cut the budget at that point for some reason, for those episodes, and the fight scenes were poorly directed. And then we touch on to other ghouls who are in Aogiri Tree, etc., and they look like interesting characters, but then we don't get to see or find out more about them. And then towards the end, there's this major big war to hunt down the owl once and for all. And then what was the point of it at the end? Oh, season 2, if this is meant to be a season 2, Tokyo Ghoul Route A is garbage. Plot-wise, just everything-wise, even the opening theme. I mean, the first season had such an amazing opening theme. If you like really good music, go and check it out. It's like a mixture of pop and alternative rock. It's done by Lin Toshites Sigure's lead vocalist, what's his name, TK. It's done by him, and it's very well done. It's a very well composed song. It's very catchy. It's a masterpiece. And then the second, the Route A, it's some shoddy, I don't know what even genre to call it, and it was just a bad opening. And Route A is garbage. It literally is. And as I said before, I'm not trying to force this on you. If you want to go check it out, be my guest. But all I can say is that animes do get remakes and alternate retellings, as we've seen down the line in anime's history. We've seen Evangelion, it can be said both ways. Most people say Evangelion. Even the people on the show say it. I like to say Evangelion because whatever, that's how I've always said it. But anyway, that's been remade already. It was originally in the 80s, 90s that show came out, and now they're redoing it in the form of feature-length films and actually including more material that they left out or changed in the original anime series. Same with Full Metal Alchemist. They did Brotherhood, which was 10 times better than the 2003 series. Not to say the 2003 series wasn't good. 2003 series actually was very good, despite not sticking entirely to the original source material. But we had Brotherhood afterwards, and Brotherhood blew it out of the park. So hopefully, if they decide to do a retelling or a remake of Tokyo Ghoul, hopefully they stick to the plot this time and we actually get to find out what is going on with the story, because Route A messed up Tokyo Ghoul. Pluses though, the art style of Tokyo Ghoul, both seasons, the art style, very good. The guy does the manga, he's just a very good artist. And his designs for the masks, he's obviously got some kind of fascination for masks, because Kaneki's mask is by far the most badass mask I've seen in the history of masks. It is scary, yet at the same time, it is freaking awesome. And for those of you who don't know, if you've seen my Twitter account and even my personal Facebook page, my profile picture is Kaneki's mask with Kaneki wearing it. So yeah, Kaneki's mask, very badass. I think the most poorly done mask had to have been Toka's. It was basically just a flat plastic, what was meant to be cute bunny mask, but that was terrible. Toka could have had a mask that was way cooler than that, but I don't know why I decided to go with a bunny. or some shit. So anyway, just doesn't fit her. So anyway, yeah, music wise, very good soundtrack. Except for the opening of Route A. Route A's opening was terrible. And yeah, with season one, fight scenes are very well directed. They're not the best I've seen, but they are very well directed. And the color palette of the series, it is a perfect mix between vibrant and dark. So that obviously works in its favor. And the overall feel of both series, what I like about it is the sense of it feels like with both sides, with the humans and the ghouls, it feels like a whole, it's almost got a Batman feel to it. And the main reason being is because it's got this whole, especially not, it's not just because everyone, well, all the ghouls wear the masks. It's just overall, there's this whole feeling of vigilantism, vigilante stuff. It's just, and revenge, etc. It's got this whole Batman feel to it. So, yeah, it makes Tokyo, instead of looking at it like we normally do in the real world, when we look at Tokyo, we think, oh, it's this bright and bustling and, you know, happy, hardworking city. This shows it from a much darker perspective, like full of just horror and stuff, kind of like what Gotham City is like, except Tokyo is obviously a lot cleaner, but nonetheless, it shows Tokyo from a darker perspective. So, yeah, that's what I will give a plus to both series of Tokyo Ghoul. And then, that concludes this review. What do you think of Tokyo Ghoul? Please leave any comments in the comments box below. And if there's something I maybe missed with this review, maybe you can also mention that in the comments. And yeah, that's about it. I'm Viking, and until next time, have a kick-ass day.